Hello students, welcome back to my channel Krida Educare. I am back with the third part of your chapter, that is tissue. In this third part we will discuss about the permanent complex tissue. We had already seen the meristematic tissue in the first part and the permanent simple tissue in the second part. I will provide you the link in my description box. Students, do watch the video till the end for clear and proper understanding, and if you find the content helping in your studies, do like, share and subscribe my channel. So, starting with our today's topic, that is your complex permanent tissue. So, the topic is yours complex permanent tissue. So before starting the complex permanent tissue, let's have a quick review of your plant tissue through a flow chart. So your plant tissue is basically divided into your two parts. We had already seen this meristematic tissue and your permanent tissue. Meristematic tissue don't have the ability to, no sorry, the meristematic tissues have the ability to divide, whereas your permanent tissue don't have the ability to divide. Now the meristematic tissue is again divided into your, how many parts? Three parts, that is your apical, intercalary and lateral. And the permanent tissue is divided into two parts, that is your simple and the complex. So the simple tissue is again divided into your, the last video we have seen three parts, parenchyma, collenchyma and the last one is your sclerenchyma. And the complex tissue is again divided into your two parts, that is your xylem and the phloem. Students, see here, we had already seen the meristematic tissue and its type in the first part. And we had also seen the simple permanent tissue and its type in the second part. And today we will see about the third, that is your complex tissue and its two part, that is your xylem and the phloem. Now the question, the main important question here arises, why this they are known as complex tissue. Why they are known as complex tissue? So the answer to this is, they are known as complex tissue because they are made up of more than one cell. They are known as complex because they are made up of, they are made up of more than one cell. And what is that cell? It can be the cell of the simple permanent tissue. Apart from the complex tissue, they are also known as the conducting tissues. The two parts, that is your xylem and phloem, they are also known as the conducting tissues. Now the question arises that why they are known as the conducting tissues. They are known as the conducting tissues because they help in the transportation of, help in transportation of organic, help in the transportation of your organic material, water and minerals up and down the plant body, up and down the plant body. So for this reason they are known, also known as the conducting tissues. So earlier also I told you that the complex tissues of two types. What are they? Xylem, and the next one is your phloem. So we will deal with each one of it, but firstly we will take the xylem tissues. As the xylem tissues are the part of your complex tissue, so they are made up of more than one cell, it is clear. So what are they cell? They are parenchymatous, as well as sclerenchymatous. This means they have a cells of parenchyma as well as the cells of sclerenchyma in it. In the simple permanent tissue, we have seen there were parenchyma, colenchyma, and sclerenchyma. So the xylem tissue has the parenchymatous as well as sclerenchymatous cell. That's why it is known as the complex tissue. As already explained to you that they are made up of more than one cell. Now, the xylem tissues are also known as the mechanical tissue. They are known as mechanical tissue. They are known as mechanical tissue because they provide the mechanical strength to the plant body. They provide mechanical strength. They provide the mechanical strength to the plant body. Apart from this, they are also known as the vascular tissues. They are known as the vascular tissues. Why they are known as the vascular tissues? They are known as the vascular tissues because they form the tubular passages. They form tubular passages to transport food and the dissolved minerals from root to the different parts of the plant. Tubular passages to transport food and minerals to all the parts of a plant body. Now, this xylem are neither living nor non-living, but they are considered as the non-living cells or the dead cells because as the xylem has the four elements, the three of them are the made up of dead cells and only one, that is xylem parenchyma, is made up of your living cell. That's why they considered they are living as well as non-living, consist of living and non-living cells. Now, as I told you, the xylem has the four components or the four elements. So we will see them one by one. Four components of xylem. So the first one is your tracheard. You can see here the four components are your tracheard, xylem parenchyma, xylem sclerenchyma, and the vessels. So firstly we will deal with the tracheard. So the tracheard is a single cell. They are single celled with the tapering end. Tapering end. They are having a single cell. They are having a tapering end. Tapering end means the pointed end. You can see in this diagram they are having a tapering end. That is the pointed end. they are the dead cells. They are made up of dead cells. The cells present is the dead cell. The walls are the thick. Although the xylems are only the thick walled, and here the trachea, the walls are thick. Why the walls are thick? Due to deposition of lignin. Due to deposition of lignin. Here there is a deposition of lignin on the walls, and this used to make the wall thick. Lumen. Suppose any tube-like structure is there. So this white space in between the tube is the, it is a tube. So the space in between the tube, that space is known as your lumen. So here the lumen is broad. You can see the lumen is broad, and it is having a pit at certain places due to non-deposition of lignin on those pits. So we can write it like this: lumen is broad with non-lignified pits at certain places. You can see the lumen is broad, the walls are thick due to deposition of lignin, but at certain places you can see the depression here. These are the pits. So why they are the pits? Because here the deposition of lignin is not there. That's why the pits are non-lignified. So the lumen is broad with non-lignified pits at certain places. So this is all about your trachea. Now the second one we will move with is your vessels. Vessels, they are multicellular tubes. They are multicellular tubes. In the trachea, we have seen that they had a single cell, but the vessels are the multicellular tubes. Multicellular tubes. The cell wall is moderately thick as compared to the trachea. Here they are not as thick as the trachea. So they are, cell wall is moderately thick. Cell wall is moderately thick as compared to trachea. They are also made up of dead cells. And here also the lumen is lignified. Lumen is broad as well as the lignified. The deposition of lignin is there on the walls. Lumen is lignified. Now, the most important thing of the vessel is that they are basically cylindrical tube-like structure lying one above the other. You can see this is one of the vessel, this is the another vessel. They are the cylinder tube like structure. They are lying one above the another. When they lie one above the another, end to end, from this end to this end, and their end gets dissolved to form the continuous channel for the flow of water and minerals. You can see this is one part of a vessel, this is the another vessel. They lie one above the another, end to end, from this end to this end. And when they lie one above the another from end to end, their ends get dissolved and form a single continuous channel for the flow of water and minerals in the plant body. So this was about your vessel, and this makes the vessel the most important element of the xylem. So the vessel, although the trachea and vessel both are the important element, but due to this the vessels become the most important cell of the xylem element. So here we complete our vessels. Now the third one is your xylem parenchyma. Xylem parenchyma can also be known as your wood parenchyma, because commonly the xylem is known as wood. So the xylem parenchyma as well as the xylem sclerenchyma can be called as wood parenchyma or wood sclerenchyma, because xylem is commonly known as wood. Xylem commonly known as wood. So, it can be called as wood parenchyma or wood sclerenchyma. Now, the third one is your xylem parenchyma. Xylem parenchyma are the living parenchymatous cell. Among all the four elements, only the xylem parenchyma or the wood parenchyma are the living cells. The rest three are the dead cells. So, they are the living cells. And the cell involved in this is the parenchymatous cells. They are living parenchymatous cells. And the deposition on its wall is not of lignin, but they have the deposition of cellulose. They have cellulose wall. They are living cells. Here you can see in the structure, they are the red color denote the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm, the red fluid, the jelly fluid like substance, cytoplasm, as well as you can see the nucleus present in it. All the living cells have a nucleus. So they are the living parenchymatous cell. They have a cellulose wall. They don't have a lignin deposition on their wall, and they perform the function of storage. The food which is prepared and which is used for the processes are being stored in this xylem parenchyma. Function of storage. So this is basically about your xylem parenchyma. Now we will move with the last element of the xylem, that is your xylem sclerenchyma, or also you can mark it as wood fibers. Xylem sclerenchyma or wood sclerenchyma or the wood fibers. So, the xylem sclerenchyma are the long, narrow, that is the lumen is not as broad. Here, they are narrow, the lumen is not as broad, and they also has a deposition of lignin on their walls, and provides the mechanical strength to the plant body. Provides the mechanical strength to the plant body. They have a tapering ends at both the sides. You can see here also it is having a pointed end, and here also it is having a pointed end. So they have a tapering ends at both the sides. They have a lignified walls, and they are also the dead cells. Tapering ends on both sides. Lignified walls, and they are also made up of dead cells. So this is about the fourth element of the xylem. Now we will see the function and the location of the xylem. Xylem. So firstly we will see the location. So the xylem is mainly present in the roots, stems, leaves of higher plants, okay, and the function, the main function of xylem is the conduction of water and minerals. Conduction of water and minerals, as well as the mechanical strength to the plant body. Mechanical strength to the plant body, as well as the wood parenchyma help in the storage. Wood parenchyma or your xylem parenchyma helps in the storage. So this is all about your xylem tissues. Now we will move with the second complex tissue, that is your phloem tissue. So our next tissue is our phloem tissues. They are also known as the complex tissue, or they are the part of a complex tissue because they are also made up of more than one type of cells. So they are parenchymatous, as well as sclerenchymatous. That means they have both the cells, that is parenchyma cells and the sclerenchyma cells present in them. And the like the xylem, they don't have a thick wall, they have a thin wall. They also consist of living as well as non-living cells. Consist of living as well as non-living cells. But in the xylem, we have seen that there are three dead cells and one living cell, that is your xylem parenchyma. But here, opposite to the xylem, they have three living cells. Three living cells and one dead cell. Like the xylem, they also have the four elements. You can see here, that is your first one is your sieve tube, then the companion cell, then phloem parenchyma and the phloem sclerenchyma. The phloem sclerenchyma are known as the dead cell. So we will look to each of the element one by one. So firstly, we will start with the sieve tube. Four elements of phloem. First one is your sieve tube. So the sieve tubes are the cylinder tubes. Cylinder tube. What do you mean by the cylinder tube? That means they are thin and slim tubes. They are thin and slim tubes, and they are arranged in a vertical manner. Vertical manner means one above the other, end to end. They are arranged in a vertical manner, one above the another, end to end. And at the end, they have a sieve plate, and that sieve plate has perforation. That means a small tiny pores present on them, that is known as your sieve pores, and this area is known as your sieve area. This area is known as the sieve area. They are the cylinder tubes, thin and slim tubes. They are arranged in a vertical manner, one above the another, end to end, and at the end they have a sieve plates. These sieve plates are perforated. Perforated means they have a small tiny pores present on its plate, and this are those pores are known as your sieve pores, and this total area is known as your sieve area. From this sieve area only the blood, the conduction of minerals, organic food takes place in the plant body. So the sieve element, the sieve tubes are the most important element of the phloem tissues. Now the sieve tubes on maturity lack the nucleus. Although they contain a dense cytoplasm, but they lack the nucleus and thus become totally dependent on the companion cell. They are present lateral to it. They are totally dependent on the companion cell. Lateral means side of the sieve tube. They become totally dependent on the companion cell for the conduction of the water and for the conduction of your organic food. So this is basically about your sieve tube. Now we will move to the next one, that is your companion cell. From the name only it is clear, companion cell. Companion means a partner. So they work in a close partnership. They work in a close partnership. As when there's a direct connection between the sieve tube and the companion cell, they both depend on each other. They work in a close partnership, because when the sieve tube on maturity lacks the nucleus, this companion cell performs the function of the sieve tube and help in the conduction of the water, help in the conduction of the organic food throughout the plant body. The companion cell have a dense cytoplasm. It has a dense cytoplasm and a nucleus present in it, and this nucleus helps in the work of the sieve tubes. Or we can say that it controls all the activity, of the sieve tube element. So here we have completed the second element, that is your companion cell. Now the third element is your phloem parenchyma. So the phloem parenchyma is also thin walled and it is a living tissue. You can see here they are also having a thin wall and they are the living tissue. They basically store food in the form of starch, fat, organic food, etc. They basically store the food in the form of starch, fat, organic food, and help in the lateral conduction of the food. Lateral means side to side conduction of the food. And the last one element of the phloem is your phloem fibers. They are the dead tissues. Till now the three elements, that is your sieve tube, companion cell and the phloem parenchyma, all were the living tissues. Now the phloem fibers, they are the dead cells, and they have the function to provide the mechanical strength in the plant body. Provides the mechanical strength to the plant body. So this is about all the elements of the phloem. Just see it once again. See, the main element of the phloem is your sieve tube. The sieve tubes are cylinder tubes, that is the thin and the slim tubes. They are arranged in a vertical manner, that is one above the another, end to end. And at the end, they have a sieve plates. These sieve plates are perforated. That means they have a fine pores present on its surface. And these pores are known as your sieve pores. And the total area is known as your sieve area. From this sieve area, only there is a conduction of the organic food in throughout the plant body. Now, this sieve tube on maturity lacks the nucleus. The nucleus gets degenerated on the maturity, although it has a dense cytoplasm. So, when the nucleus gets degenerated, the sieve tubes are totally dependent on the another cell, that is your companion cell. Now, we will move to the second one, that is your companion cell. From the name only, you can understand companion means partner. So, the sieve tubes and the companion cell work in a close partnership. There is a direct connection between the sieve tube and the companion cell. So, when the this companion cell is present on the lateral side of the sieve tube and when and controls all the activity of the your sieve tube. So, when the sieve tube lacks the nucleus and maturity, the companion cell helps in the lateral conduction of the lateral conduction of the organic food throughout the plant body. The next one is your phloem parenchyma. They are also the living tissues. They are thin walls, and the phloem parenchyma helps basically in the storage of the food in the form of your starch, fat, organic food. And the phloem fibers, all the three elements till now were the living tissues. Only the phloem fibers are your dead tissues, and they provide the mechanical strength to the plant body. Now we will see the location and the functions of the phloem. So basically the phloem is present throughout the plant, and the main function of the phloem is transportation of organic food. And the phloem, your phloem parenchyma helps in the lateral conduction of food. Phloem parenchyma helps in lateral conduction of food, and the phloem sclerenchyma or the phloem fibers, they are used in making of the ropes and the rough cloth. Phloem fibers helps in making of ropes and rough cloth. And among your xylem and phloem, phloem are present on the outer side as compared to the xylem. Suppose this is the bark of a tree. So the phloem are present on the outer sides. Phloem will be present here in this side, and your xylem will be present in the inner side. So this is basically your phloem and it is your xylem. So this is all about your conducting tissues. And with this complex tissues or the conducting tissues, we have completed your plant tissue. From the fourth part, we will start with the animal tissue. So till then, watch the videos of the plant tissues and press the bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.